Hey everybody, and welcome back to Angling Archaeology, and this week I go back to another state sale. But this time, I pick up a mystery tackle box. That's right, I got this Plano right here for $17.50. I have no idea what's inside, so let's see how well I did. Before we dive into this puppy right here, I want to show you the estate sale itself. I don't think I've ever been to one that was this packed. And it was everything from trains, to chalk art, to vintage chewing tobacco of all things, to brewery collectibles. I mean, you name it, this guy had it. So, you'll see it. Just check this out.
I'll be honest, I don't even know where to begin with this estate sale. They had everything from Christmas, to chalk art, to chew. That's right, chewing tobacco. To trains. You can see right here, just an incredible collection of ceramic, old school liquor bottles. All these were train sets, more train sets. And here's some, I mean, just an incredible collection of chalk art right here. I mean, I don't know that I've ever seen this much chalk art anywhere ever. This could be in a museum. It was really impressive. Once again, more trains. If you're into trains, this would have been your place. They had a really cool old school bowling alley, kind of pinball shuffleboard thing over there in the corner. And yep, shocker, more trains. But this was the most jam-packed estate sale I've ever been to in my entire life. Every square inch of this house was packed full of not only products, but people as well. More trains. And more ceramic bottles. I like these. A lot of these look like Bert, so I figured, you know, at least get a picture of them. But they had it all. There's the chew.
And this is really what angling archaeology is all about, is finding vintage lures and tackle out in the wild. I mean, this is a ton of fun right here. So we're going to start off. We got a Plano 6300. Nice box right here. Two-tone. You got an olive with kind of an army green on the bottom right there. It looks like it's got some sun fade. Maybe something was on top of it, which did protect the top of it, but unfortunately the front end of it, not so much. So, but all in all, really, it's in pretty good shape. At least the exterior is. So let's take a look at the inside and see what we're working with. All right, starting off on the left-hand side, we've got what appears to be either a Yakima flatfish or a Lure Jensen quickfish. But nice little pool right there. We got some terminal tackle. We've got, you know, kind of the standard Arbogast hula popper. It's almost in every single tackle box. Got a smaller version of that as well too. And then some old school hook. I mean, look at this. Look at these old school Weber hooks. The card on that. Wow. That is old. And then this. Woo-hoo-hoo! That's what I'm talking about right here. This is what you go for, to try to find a vintage pre-Rapala Storm in the original plastic case. I mean, look at that. Really nice shape right there. Little oxidation on that side. But dang! And then with the original card? Whoa! I'd say so far so good. All right, so this is a three-tray storage here. Let's get to tray number two. It looks like tray number two is more or less kind of your crappie baits. They've got a really nice old school bobber there. It's got some good character on it. Just, you know, kind of typical crappie baits. Some new old stock bets still in the original package here. 99 cents. Can't go wrong there. Hey, you can still use those today. You got a little feather jig. You've got, appears to be a little fly or something over here. moving down, we've got a spoon here. This looks to be like a lure Jensen Shyster. I bet that's what that is. That'll catch everything though. Neat color. He's got a lot of these little spoons too, it looks like. Not sure what that is. Here's another one. And then we've got just traditional old school spoon. And we got the spoon plug right here. Let's see if it's the actual spoon plug. It's kind of hard to tell. It's a spoon. I can't tell if it says plug. Well, either way, I mean, that's what that is. And then just kind of some random stuff. Nothing too crazy. Then obviously here we've got, you know, some soft plastics, some little grubs, so you get some jig heads. So, okay, cool. Bottom drawer, what do we got here? Nice little inline spinner combo. Three. Here's some of those spoons that they had on. Mike's Shad. There we go. Never heard of Mike's Shad before. Unused. Here's some Blakemore grubs. And got some more terminal tackle. Ooh, what is this? Now this is cool stuff right here. Look at this. I love that packaging. Wolf Fang. That is awesome. I mean, just frame that, put that on your wall. That is super cool and probably very old. I don't know much about Wolf Fang. If you do, comment down below. I'm not sure. Here's some more snelled hooks right here. That's awesome. Look at that, the artwork on there. You can tell that's old school. Here's some eagle claws. This looks like a newer one. This looks older. That's pretty sweet. Alright, what else we got here? Looks like just some more terminal tackle. And your swivels, more swivels. Typical stuff you see in most tackle boxes. We have here the reel. Zebco ZX8 Stingray. Never seen this one, but cool. There you go. And of course, any vintage tackle box would not be complete without a Zebco D-Liar. Everyone's got a D-Liar. There you go. Of course. And this, I don't know if I'm saving the best for last or what, but how old is that? Look at that. Oh my gosh. That is crazy. Folks, when do you think this was made? Put it down below. I have no idea. Is this made to look old? Is this really old? I got a feeling this is like seriously old stuff, like from the 50s or before. I don't know. But that is really, really cool. Now, one thing outside the tackle box that I got, and this was for $3, so I had to pick it up. An old school Zebco, new in box. I can't say for certain if this is the actual correct Zebco that came with the box. But yeah, the Zebco here, looks like it's actually gently used. But what's cool about it, it's got the original paperwork. So you got all that stuff right there. I'll send that in, make sure I get my warranty for this. But, hey, anytime I can find a reel in box, that may not go with this one, but still, the box by itself is pretty awesome. I mean, to get that kind of combo for $3, why not? So I'm going to go ahead and just put everything away, and then I'm going to post this on eBay for anybody who might be interested in it. In my opinion, this old school woof fang and, you know, these old nylon snelled hooks, I mean, you could just put like some kind of card backing on this and then, you know, frame it and put it on a wall. That'd be just really cool art. These Fluger hooks and, I mean, the thin fin in the original package, all that together to me is probably worth at least $17 right there. And then everything else, you know, is just a bonus. So this is cool. I really like that a lot, but that'll be for sale on eBay. I'm really trying to encourage everybody to get out there and find lures out in the wild, whether that's a garage sale, estate sale, you name it. If you can find it out there, it's a lot of fun to collect this stuff, to resell it, to cast it. So it's just a ton of fun. I just encourage you guys to get out there and do the same. It's just a blast. Now, old Bass and Bert here, he's a little camera shy, doesn't like to get on here too much, and that's okay, Bert. You don't have to. But I got him a couple things at the estate sale as well. With all that chalk art, I figured, hey, why not get a little Bert lookalike? And then they had a ton of decanters. What more fitting for old Bass and Bert than this one right here? I'm sorry, I mean, is that spitting image? Booze hound? You gotta get that. Well, that's going to do it for this episode of Angling Archaeology, where we unearth the good old days. I want to thank everybody for liking, subscribing, watching, commenting, all the above. And if you haven't done so already, please do. Please like, subscribe, tell your friends, tell your family. Shout out from the rooftops. I really enjoy giving everybody their weekly dose of AA. This is just a lot of fun for me. So until next time, folks, we'll see you on the water.